just heading over to the hotel to speak to the barman about crew drinks.
Well, let us know how you get on.
Oh, Ruby, you have any problems? Just you call me.
I'll ring JP.
What's happening? Oh, Ruby, have you forgotten something?
Baby steps, JP. Baby steps. Someone has got.
Yes, one more thing, sir. I requested footage recorded the day Katrina was killed. Just to see if there were intentions amongst the crew, sir.
3 months traveling and working together? How did you take a toll?
Yeah. I came across this, recorded at the end of the day, just as they were about to finish.
Perfect, Katrina. Andy, keep rolling. I want some GVs.
This is just visual shots, sir. But the sound does keep on recording, and it picked up a conversation between Terry and Katrina. So she says, I should never have told you. Now, what was she referring to, sir? Her affair with Andy?
Terry was jealous. Disapproving, maybe?
On our recording, sir, he does sound a little bit.
It's really not out.
Where is Terry? Where is
Katrina and me? We've been working on the show since the beginning. We're all friends.
Yes, but on that recording, you can't deny it. You do sound a little
intense.
I don't have romantic feelings for Katrina, if that's what you're thinking. But she did mean an awful lot to me.
Doesn't mean grown close over the years.
Yeah. We all spent our days off together, the pair of us. Seeing the sights, sampling local culture. Most of the crew give a wide berth of the boring old sound guy. But Katrina was different. Never judged people.
So what was Katrina referring to? She said she wished she'd never told you.
About a week ago, she informed me that she intended to leave Hotspots.
Would I stop presenting it to me?
Saying softly that I am, I'm taking the news particularly well. Thought of doing this without her.
Who else knew? Terry. Katrina decided to leave the show. She told Bill Calder over in Texas.
That seems to me.
Going to quit.
It makes me wonder. Hotspot's producer was aware of the star of the show and plans to leave. We need to chase Katrina's agent.
So, let me get this straight, Andre. The bottles of beer that the TV crew drank from are going to be somewhere here. Am I right?
Don't fancy giving a young police officer a hand, do you?
Sorry.
Well, thanks for nothing. All right, Ruby Patterson. Time to show the world what you are made of.
From what I can tell, Bill Calder can be quite the aggressor. He recently fell out with the unions over claims he pays low wages and doesn't follow regulations. And by all accounts, he used some pretty nasty tactics to win the case. You still haven't spoken to the agent.
It's on hold.
Dreadful. Who chose this? I mean, what's wrong with being a bit of the old Vivaldi's or a nice show tune, maybe?
Hello? Mr. Harrington. Thank you for finding a way to talk to me.
Jack Mooney speaking.
What's the last?
Darnell. Oh, lovely to hear from you.
Oh, sure.
Oh, Sherman? He's just dandy.
Yeah.
Tell you, the hairy scamp could not be better.
Are you sure that's what Katrina did after she spoke to you?
Okay, Darnell. All the best. Yeah. Speak soon. Seems Mrs. Darnell has come around to the idea of having an animal in the house sooner than expected. Well, let's not worry about that now. So, tell me, what did the agent have to say for himself?
6 months ago, Jake Harrington informed Bill Carr that Katrina wanted to leave, and Bill was not happy about it.
He was refusing to let her go.
and that's why he and Katrina spoke the night before last.
Funny how he never mentioned that. Look, all right, I admit, I might have been somewhat selective with the truth. But yes, Katrina came to see me that night. Must have been after 11. She seemed tipsy. I said I thought it unwise to talk shop if she'd been drinking, but she was adamant.
Do you talk about her leaving the show?
Something I don't refute, I was very reticent to let her do.
Can I ask why?
Because presenters like Katrina come along once in a blue moon. She had this very natural girl next door quality about her. Makes you in public think she's one of them.
Well, what did you talk about that night?
I told Katrina she had a legal commitment to film another 3 series, and I expected her to honor it. She said I gave her no choice but to break her contract and go. I promptly emailed my lawyers and told them to prepare for court.
But Katrina had made up her mind. Taking legal action really have made any difference?
Probably not. We hear you can be quite tired of the bill.
You don't get what you want.
Vicious. That's what show business does to you. Lots of sharks swimming about the waters. It's a case of eat or be eaten.
But that's an unfortunate analogy.
So what happens next? With enough footage of Katrina to cobble together our final episode of this series, we'll recast for the next.
You're thinking about recasting? Already? Poor girl's only been dead 24 hours.
As they say, the show must go on.
Mr. Calder, does the word Meriden mean anything to you?
Sorry?
Meriden. It's a beta blocker. With a large trace of it found in Katrina's system.
Never heard of the stuff.
Well, Ruby, what's the story?
Okay, so Bill Calder actually ordered and paid for all the beers.
So in theory, Bill could have added the Meridals to one of the beers before handing it to Katrina. So take me through what you found.
So the crew drank palm tree beers. So I started by separating out the bottles with that label on it. I then dusted those very same bottles for fingerprints and separated them out into 3 further groupings. Ones with no prints belonging to our suspects, ones with one set of suspect prints on them, and ones with more than one set of suspect prints on them.
Excellent work. So which pile is which?
I think,
You forgot, haven't you?
No. Oh, and you
mentioned
the label
files. Not to worry. Let's work out which is which. Won't take us long together. And then you can get them off to the lab. So, Ruby, would it be right in saying that remembering things is not one of your strong points?
You just noticed. It's like my one flaw as a human being. You know people say that memory's like a sieve? Well, mine's like a bucket. A bottomless one.
So, this fella, Bill Calder. He leaps to the top of the leaderboard, from prime suspect, numero uno.
He does one. He has a motive. Katrina was a desperate team past bus, and Bill's a ruthless man. The kid's not getting his own way.
Now we know it's been a grueling couple of months traveling together. So Katrina's decision to quit really just tipped over the edge.
Number two, when we asked him if he heard what the mayor did, well, he was acting very shifty.
Certainly was, yes. Number three, Bill Calder ordered beers for the crew drinks, which is when he could have poisoned Katrina with the marathon. Except, same problem exists. If he drug Katrina's beer down at the bar earlier that evening...
Death in Paradise, I think it's called.